John Pombe Magufuli was elected Tanzanian president in 2015. He had campaigned and promised to protect the natural wealth and end the bureaucracy and government offices. He pledged to run the economy that would create opportunities for the youth and reduce the growing gap between the rich and the poor. Prior to his candidacy, and having served in government for a number of years, he had not been implicated in any corruption scandal. He was never directly associated with any corruption deal. This clean record is extremely rare in politics. His stance to want to improve the lives of ordinary Tanzanians was seen as controversial and an attack on foreign investment. The Magufuli administration clamped down on foreign investor exemptions and strengthened its revenue collection, while foreign investment fell by 43% in the year after Magufuli entered office in October 2015, the Tanzanian GDP continued to grow at an average of around 6% a year. This was backed by a strong performance in sectors including light manufacturing, mining, agriculture, and logistics. The Magufuli administration adopted a zero-tolerance policy on corruption, and this made engagement with local authorities much easier. Unlike other African presidents, Tanzanian President John Magufuli made headlines when he canceled a Chinese loan worth $10 billion signed by his predecessor, Jakaya Kikwete, to construct a port at Imbekani Creek in Bagamoyo over terms and conditions that would say that the Chinese would have the guaranteed loan and 99 years uninterrupted lease. Magufuli said that the conditions beat the logic and that the terms of this agreement could only be accepted by a drunkard. The terms included that the Chinese investor will build the port on the condition that they get 30 years to guarantee on the loan and 99 years uninterrupted lease. The other condition was that the Tanzanian government would have absolutely no power to raise concerns on whoever invests in the port during that period.
Maana yake, you are not allowed to construct any port.
Magufuli called this a killer Chinese loan.
We are supposed to change.
The historic relations between Tanzania and Zambia have always been cordial. In 1966, Tanzanian President Julius Nyerere was invited by the Zambian President Kenneth Kaunda to give an address at the inauguration ceremony of the University of Zambia campus. The Tanzanian and Zambian government agreed in 1968 to construct a railway line from Lusaka, the capital of Zambia, to the port of Dar es Salaam in Tanzania. The Tazara Railway Line, as it was called, was designed and constructed between 1968 and 1976. This was China's first ever technical and financial international development project. In 1997, Julius Nyerere would visit Kenneth Kaunda, who at that time had been incarcerated by the Chiluba administration. Kenneth Kaunda had declared a hunger strike, but this was broken when he and Nyerere, it is said, shared orange juice and a biscuit. Nyerere met with the Chiluba administration to demand the release of Kenneth Kaunda. Kenneth Kaunda was released and placed on house arrest. On October 5th, 2019, Joseph Magufuli and Edgar Lungu, who is the President of the Republic of Zambia, officially launched the Tunduma and Nakonde one-stop border post. The Tunduma-Nakonde border is the busiest transit and entry point in Tanzania, linking transit trade destined for the Democratic Republic of Congo, Malawi, and Zimbabwe. In 2020, Magufuli made international headlines when he chose to take a critical look at the general global consensus being enforced on how governments should combat the pandemic. By April 2020, he had stopped reporting COVID figures and declared Tanzania COVID-free. He campaigned for a second term, and in October 2020, he was reelected, no doubt by the following results from his first term as president. In his discipline in the public service, he removed from the government payroll over 15,000 staff that were employed with fraudulent academic credentials. There were also 19,000 ghost workers removed from the payroll. This resulted in over 74,000 new employees with relevant qualifications being employed. In regards to education, we see that Magufuli created a conducive environment for education. From when he got into 2015 to when he was ending his first term in 2020, there is an increase of enrollments from those in grade one, those in secondary school, and those in university. Within the healthcare service, he had found in 2015 8,783 health outlets. By the time he was ending his first term, he had increased that to 14,479. In regard to healthcare workers, he had found in 2015 about 86,000, and he increased it to 100,000. There was also a 90% increase in trained expert doctors. John Magufuli was an incorruptible president who put Tanzania first. His economic report card shows that investing in building your citizens will in turn build the country.
The transport between Ikome and Nyakariro was very bad. That's why you can see a lot of people there just celebrating, enjoying the outcome of this CCM manifesto. I'm sure you don't want to hear that, but that is the reality.
He was only getting started, and Africa admired him for that.
Tanzania, oi.